There are a lot of different math notations that all mean derivative. So in this video, I want to go through and show you a few of these common different notations that we use from time to time. Probably the most popular one that you're likely already familiar with, if you know what a derivative is f prime of x, f prime of x. And so that would be the derivative of f of x. All right, so below each one of these, I'll show you just a quick example. If you're original function was, let's say, x cubed. That's your function. Then to use this notation, it's very straightforward. You'd say f prime of x is 3x squared. You'd use your derivative rules, right? So we bring the power down and whatnot. But the point is that the notation to say derivative is f prime. All right, the next notation is possibly a new one for you. So dydx, we use this all the time, practically just as much as f prime of x. Let me explain the context here. That previous example where we wrote f of x equals x squared, we've seen plenty of examples in the past where not everything is written in function notation. There are even equations that aren't functions if they don't pass the vertical line test, like a circle or something. So not everything can be expressed with this function notation with the f. What if it was simply y equals x squared? We would still understand what it means. But it's just a little different. It's written as an equation here with y as opposed to f. So this notation simply means take the derivative of y with respect to x. So a lot of times people in algebra classes were taught that slope, which is what derivative tells you, is rise over run, right? Rise over run. Well, that's kind of what's going on here. This is the change in y over the change in x. We're finding the derivative of y, the rate of change of y, with respect to whatever x is doing. Okay, so that's kind of a slope notation there. So it's very easy to use. If y equals x squared, we would say dy dx, which is read in English as the derivative of y with respect to x, would be 2x. The derivative is taken exactly the same way. It's just a new notation. It's just a new way of writing things down. This notation is extremely helpful when we get into some applications and some like related rates problems and optimization problems later in the course, because we might be finding the change in height over time, right, of a falling object or something like that. So that might be expressed as dh dt. That's the change in height over time, or the derivative of the height function with respect to t, which is time. Or change in money, dp dt, change in principal over change in time, or change in area or volume over change in time. This notation is extremely helpful when we have different variables like that. Number three looks a lot like number two, but it's a little different. If you just put d dx but without a y, this is expressing the derivative as an operator, which is something you're about to do to something, but you haven't written down of what yet. So let me show you how this is used. If you had d dx of the square root of x, what that means is I'm about to take the derivative of this thing. I'm about to differentiate the square root function, but I haven't yet. But I'm going to. It's an operator. It's something I'm going to do to an expression. So what I would probably do is I would probably rewrite the square root function first as x to the 1/2. Now, does this mean that I've differentiated the square root function? No, the operator is still here. I simply rewrote the square root of x as x to the 1/2, which are perfectly equivalent. Then I'm ready to use the power rule. So I'm going to apply this derivative operator and I'd get 1/2 x to the minus 1/2. And notice the d dx is gone because I've taken my derivative now. I've applied that operation. You probably clean this up, 1 over 2 square root of x, simplify it. And this will be your final operation. But we see how this is helpful for like defining derivative rules and whatnot, because it's the derivative of things that I have not quite taken the derivative of yet. Y prime, this is an obvious one. I'm not really going to do a lot with this one. We'll just do one trig example, if you had y equals secant of x, then the derivative of secant would be secant tangent. All right, if you have not watched those videos yet or are not concerned with the derivative of trig functions, that's not the important part. The important part is understanding the notation. If y equals secant x, then its derivative would be y prime. That's all we need to gather from this. All right, last one. This is probably the least commonly used. Capital D sub x of an expression. This is an operator as well. Like I said, we don't use it super, super often, but if we do, it's good to know. The way you'd use it is D sub x of an expression. You just type whatever you want to take the derivative of in here. Let's say x squared minus 7x plus 1. That's not the derivative. That's what we want to take the derivative of. Its derivative would be 2x minus 7 using basic derivative rules. Here's the derivative, and notice the operator is gone now, right? We've gotten rid of it. So we're going to use these for the entire rest of the semester, all of these, with maybe an exception of the last one. But I just wanted to introduce you to all these various notations that all equivalently mean derivative.